Welcome students again into the well science chemistry class. Now from last four lecture we are learning the new chapter number 4, thermodynamics and energetics. Now in the last lecture we learned about the pressure volume type of work. We know that work W is equal to minus P external pressure external into delta V. Up to this we learn. Again we learn the pre-expansion, that is the work in the vacuum. And the next topic now is the units of energy and work. These are also very important. Now this is the fixed, that is the unit as 1 joule is what? 1 joule is nothing but 1 kilogram meter square per second square. Now this is the 1 joule. And if we have to convert this joule into the Pascal, then it becomes 1 joule is equal to 1 Pascal per meter cube. 1 joule means what? 1 joule means 1 Pascal per cube. Now 1 Pascal is what? 1 Pascal is equal to 1 kilogram per meter per centimeter, sorry, second square. Now here, what is there? Now here is the meter square, but here is the meter cube. And so 1 Pascal that becomes as 1 kilogram per meter per second square. Now this is about the Pascal. We know this formula W is equal to minus P external into delta V. Now put the value of pressure in this equation in bar, and volume, that is the delta V, is in decimeter cube. Then if pressure is expressed in bar, bar is also unit of the pressure, and changing volume is expressed in decimeter cube, then what is there? Then the work W is equal to the unit of work becomes bar per decimeter cube. Bar into decimeter cube. Now 1 bar means how many Pascal? 1 bar means 10^5 Pascal. Now if we substitute the value of Pascal as kilogram per meter per second square, then what that becomes? 1 bar is equal to 10^5 kilogram per meter per second square. Because this kilogram per meter per second square is nothing but the Pascal. See here, Pascal is nothing but 1 Pascal is equal to 1 kilogram per meter square per second square. So substitute the value of 1 bar as 10^5 Pascal. Pascal is nothing but this unit. Then what we obtain? And we know that the work has the unit of bar into decimeter cube. So if we take this unit of work as bar into decimeter cube, I only write here first decimeter cube and then bar. What is the unit of work? Bar into decimeter cube, because pressure is expressed in bar and volume is expressed in decimeter. So bar into decimeter cube, I only write here decimeter cube into bar, that is the difference. So this is nothing but the work W. So we want to calculate here unit of work, because we are interested in unit of work. So this is the SI unit of work, that is bar into decimeter cube. Now only substitute the value of bar here, decimeter cube remains as it is. So here decimeter cube into what is the bar? Bar means 10^5 Pascal. So here substitute this bar as 10^5 Pascal. But what is Pascal? Pascal is nothing but kilogram per meter per second square. So this is the Pascal. Now this becomes, now if we want to convert the decimeter cube into meter cube, then what is the relation between decimeter cube and meter cube? 1 decimeter cube is equal to 10^-3 meter cube. Now remember student, this is very important. 1 decimeter cube is equal to 10^-3 meter cube. So substitute the value of decimeter cube as 10^-3 meter cube. I only write here first meter cube and then this 10^-3. See this. This is nothing but this is the decimeter cube. 1 decimeter cube is nothing but 10^-3 meter cube. And this is as per second square. Now here this meter cube and this minus 1 meter, that becomes meter square, because 3 minus 1 becomes 2. So meter. And here this second square as it is, and this 10 raised to 5 and 10 raised to minus 3 become 10 raised to 2. 10 raised to 2 means 100. 10 raised to 2 means 100. So this quantity becomes as 100 kilogram meter square per second. Now we know that kilogram meter square per second square, what is that? Kilogram meter square per second square is nothing but 1 joule. So what is this quantity? This is joule. Joule is equal to kilogram per meter square per second square. Here also kilogram per meter square per second square. So 100 kilogram per meter square per second square means 100 joules. So remember here now, what is this conversion? This conversion is of 1 decimeter cube bar. Now 1 decimeter cube bar, that is W, the unit of W, bar becomes 100 joule. Now let us solve the problem based on this unit. Now what is this problem number 4.1 here? What is in that problem? What they ask us? They ask us to calculate the work in decimeter cube bar and in joule. Now what is given? 3 moles of an ideal gas is given. Number of moles is 3. But in our formula of calculation of the work, there is no, that is the number of moles. That is N is not there. So though they give here us the value of number of moles, but in formula that is not there. So only remember that is the 3 moles. But in formula this value is not taken. Now 3 moles of an ideal gas are expanded isothermally at a constant temperature. Isothermal means at constant temperature from 15 decimeter cube, that is the volume V1, 15 decimeter cube means, to 20 decimeter cube, V2. How we calculate this delta V? V2 minus V1. So here two values of volume are given, that is the 15 decimeter cube and 20 decimeter. And constant external pressure is also given, PEX. This is also given. And what is that? 1.2 bar. So we obtain our work in bar per decimeter cube. And then we have to convert. Estimate the amount of work in decimeter cube bar. That is, we already obtained after substituting this value. And that decimeter cube in bar, we have to convert into joule. How we convert? This 1 decimeter cube bar is equal to 100 joule. Then how many work we obtain in decimeter cube bar? Only multiply that by the 100 joule. You obtain the work in 100. Now let us solve this problem. How they solve this problem? Let us see. First write down the notes by taking the screenshot. Now we have to calculate the value of the work in decimeter cube bar and joule. Now let us solve this problem, student. Very simple problem. Here we have given the initial pressure. The value of initial pressure P1 is given, 15 decimeter cube. The value of final pressure is also given, 20 decimeter cube. Again the value of external pressure is given, 1.2 bar. Now what is our formula? W is equal to minus P external into delta V. How delta V is calculated? V2 minus V1. So W is equal to minus P external into V2 minus V1. Now substitute only the values. W is equal to minus 1.2 bar in bracket. V2 is 20 decimeter cube minus 50. That becomes 5 decimeter cube. So minus 1.2 bar into 5 decimeter cube. That becomes this. Multiply it with, then the value is minus 6.0 bar per decimeter cube. Now minus 6.0 means minus 6. Okay. Now we know that 1 decimeter cube bar is equal to 100 joule. Just we learned that. We convert the decimeter cube bar value as a 100 joule. Now minus 6.0 decimeter cube. Bar means minus 6.0 into 100, and that becomes minus 6.0 means minus six into 100, minus 600 joule. So the work in joule in this problem, they ask us to calculate the work in joule. So that is W is equal to minus 600 joule. Now let us learn the second numerical or second problem 4.2. But here we have to calculate the external pressure, and they given us the value of here is the pressure is not given, volume is given, V1 and V2. By mistake, the value becomes as here. I write here V1 and V2, but it is the volume that is given. Now see here, in this problem 4.2, what is that problem that is very important? Now calculate the constant external pressure. That means P external we have to calculate here. Required to compress. Now this is the work of compression. 2 moles of an ideal gas. The number of moles is given, but that is not in the formula. Okay. And the compression is from volume 25 decimeter cube to 13. As it is the compression, the V1 volume, that is the initial volume, has the large value. See here, 25 decimeter cube. And after compression, volume becomes decreased. And so the value is only 30 decimeter cube, that is the V2. Then they have again given, when the work obtained is 4862.4 joule. Now here work is positive, so definitely it is the work of compression, because work of expansion is negative, but work of compression is positive, because the value V2 is less, and V2 minus V1 is again the negative value, and negative becomes positive. Now see here the value of V1 is more, 25, and value of V2 is less. If we substitute here, less minus more, it becomes negative. And this twin formula there is also negative. So negative becomes what? Positive. So here compression work. As compression, volume decreases from 25 to 13. So the work of compression is positive there. Now this is the value of work. Now first convert the value of work into decimeter cube bar. And then we can calculate the external pressure. So what is our formula? W is equal to minus P external delta V into is equal to minus P external V2 minus V. That is our formula. But first convert the this value of work into the decimeter cube bar. Now this formula we know that 100 joule is equal to 1 decimeter cube bar. Then how many joule of work is here? 4867.4. So that becomes cross multiplication. So this into 1 decimeter cube bar is joule, decimeter cube bar divided by this 100. Now this joule get cancelled here. Then the work is directly converted into the this 4862.4 divided by 100 means 48.624. This point comes here as there is divided by 100. And the unit is now decimeter cube bar. Now this is the value of work. Now substitute this value of work in our this formula. What given value of work is there? P external they have to ask us. V2 we know 30 and V1 is 25. Now let us substitute all these values and let us calculate the external pressure. Now how it is calculated? First write down the screenshot. Take the screenshot and write down the note first, and then we will calculate that. P external we have to calculate now. Now calculate or substitute the values of V2 and V1. Now here I substitute all these values. Now this 48.624 decimeter bar and minus V external. Now what is V2 here? V2 is 13 decimeter cube. is V1? 25 decimeter. So this becomes 13 minus 25 minus 12. Because this 25 is greater than here is minus 7. And this pH. Now minus minus becomes plus. So 12 decimeter cube into this pH kernel. Minus minus become plus. And here is this. Now we have to calculate this pH kernel. So take the pH kernel as this side. This becomes divided. So pH kernel is equal to 8.624 divided by 12 decimeter cube. Now this decimeter cube get cancelled. Now it is only the unit of bar, that is the value unit of pressure. So pH kernel is equal to now 12 4 jar 48 12 5 jar 60, and this 12 2 jar 24. So 4.52 bar is the value of pH kernel. Now in this way, student, we have to solve the numericals based on the formula, that is the W is equal to minus P external into delta V. There are always numericals on this topic in the JEE CET. So try to solve maximum numericals. Again, 4.3 is also given there. You have to solve that, and then we will see the next topic into the next video. But you like, subscribe and share this video to the other 12 science students, so that they also get the benefit how to solve the numericals confidently in examination in JEE CET or into the board examination. Thank you for watching this video. Thank you very much. Take the screenshot again and solve this. Write down the notes into the notebook.